Welcome to Opalesque TV. I'm Greg Despolbear, and today I'm in the office of Pan Reliance, a fund of hedge funds group, and I'm with one of the co-founders, Amanda Haynes-Dale. Amanda is a pioneer in the hedge fund world. She's one of the first successful female fund managers to crack the industry. Amanda, can you give us a little bit of background on your history and Pan Reliance?
Pan Reliance is a boutique fund of hedge funds that has a multiple onshore and offshore offerings for U.S. and non-U.S. investors. And primarily these offerings are multi-strategy funds of hedge funds.
Amanda, how did you get your start in the hedge fund industry?
I had been a money manager at Wertheim, which is now part of Morgan Stanley. And I started a brokerage firm in the early 1980s. And I had hedge funds as clients of my broker-dealer. And I was giving out my money and that of my clients to hedge fund managers on an informal basis. Then in January 1 of 1991, I decided to formalize the process and create Pan Multi-Strategy, my first fund of hedge funds. And I thought it would be a great complement to my long-only, traditionally run portfolios, because Pan Multi-Strategy would be offering very attractive risk-adjusted returns.
Given that there were far fewer hedge funds when you started, can you tell us about some of your early allocations and how you chose to allocate in the late 80s and early 90s?
Well, first of all, it was completely different. It was before Hedge Fund Research, Inc., you know, had their four style buckets and their 22 sub-strategies. You didn't have any of those categorization schemes then. And there were probably only, there were only a few big name hedge funds, and the rest were smaller hedge fund managers. It was a couple of guys and a phone. And what I really focused on at that time was talent and the hedge fund manager's background and provenance and what his particular investment philosophy was. And I made allocations, you know, accordingly. And interestingly enough, many of my early hedge fund managers just had a few million dollars under management. Mark Kingdon would be one who used to have an office right across the hall from me. And there again, at that time, it was a couple of guys and a phone. But Mark had already had two or three years under his belt. He had been managing money actually for quite a long time for, you know, for other people. And he had a very clear and defined multi-styled strategy that I found particularly appealing at the time. He's now gone on to run multiple billions. Another example would be David Einhorn. He and Jeff Keswin were teamed up. Very deep value, Graham and Dodd. He'd come from a wonderful background, and we also made an allocation to him when he only had a few million under management. He now has gone on to have multiple billions of dollars under management, is closed frequently to new investors, and was the manager who, remember, shorted Lehman Brothers way before it was fashionable. In many instances, I felt that I had an edge with some of these managers because I wasn't just, you know, looking at their then limited track records and going over their bios, but in fact, they had been clients of my broker-dealer that I had been discussing individual positions with them.
Amanda, what were the difficulties you encountered in the early years of your fund of hedge funds?
Funds of hedge funds were a new concept then. And I had to educate investors that there was a difference between absolute returns and risk-adjusted returns, and that funds of hedge funds were going to be giving them risk-adjusted returns. And what happened in the 1990s, it was a bull market, and the S&P 500 was skyrocketing upwards. And we were, as expected, underperforming. But then the 2002 bear market came around, and we way outperformed the S&P 500 index, and our clients were rewarded.
Amanda, tell us about your investment philosophy and how you select managers with whom to invest.
Well, with 35 years of money management experience, I have applied my early lessons on money management to funds of hedge funds. And when allocating to a hedge fund manager, I have a view of sticking with that manager through many cycles. I have a long-term view as long as that manager sticks to his mandate. And this results in very low turnover. We also are constantly on the search for emerging managers who might be doing something that would complement the portfolio. As an example, although historically we've never made allocations to any commodity trading advisors, we've recently added a commodity equity market neutral manager whom we feel will complement our portfolio right now.
Since you are a long-term investor, what would make you redeem from a manager?
Well, we monitor our managers, you know, very closely. And one of the reasons would be if there was style drift. If you'd hired a manager to invest in U.S. value stocks and you looked at his top 10 positions and he was invested in primarily in Latin American small cap stocks. Second reason would be if there were regulatory issues. If you found out that the SEC was launching a big investigation and Wells notices were going out. Third reason would be if there were organizational issues like an exodus of key personnel. And lastly, if there was unusually poor performance relative to the manager's peer group on a monthly or quarterly basis.
Historically, women are underrepresented in the hedge fund industry in comparison to other financial industries. Can you talk about any changes you see in this pattern?
Yes, they have been underrepresented in hedge funds and funds of hedge funds, and I do see very positive changes. An example of that would be the creation of 100 women in hedge funds. A second example would be that Morgan Stanley has recently created a program for emerging managers and women-owned business enterprises. And third of all, I'm seeing many institutions out there that have mandates to make allocations to women-owned business enterprises.
Amanda, what has caused the backlash against fund-of-funds over the last few years?
Due to the lack of education, a lot of investors who were in the market in 2008 thought they were buying into an absolute return vehicle when they invested in a hedge fund or a fund of hedge funds. And they thought that that meant that they were absolutely going to get returns no matter what. And in the 2008 financial crisis, many hedge funds and funds of hedge funds were down, most were. And there were issues of lack of liquidity, and there were side pockets, and there were gates that were put down. And this created disenchantment with investors. However, at the end of the day, it's important to remember that at the end of 2008, that the hedge fund and fund of hedge funds indices had substantially outperformed the global equity indices throughout that very, very difficult period. We actually saw the crisis as an opportunity to create a special situation, special opportunities fund of hedge funds that could take advantage of the dislocation in the credit markets. In particular, the focus was on distressed hedge fund managers.
Amanda, how have hedge funds and fund of hedge funds changed over the last 20 years in your eyes?
Oh, they've changed dramatically because there's been so much institutionalization of the industry. And there are positives and negatives that go with that. The positives are that institutions have now recognized that hedge funds and funds of hedge funds are an important asset class to be added to their traditional long-only portfolios. And additionally, there is tremendous transparency now that you didn't have 20 years ago. Although there is a negative, and that negative is that many institutions are now becoming paralyzed by a lot of box checking rather than focusing on superior managers who've been delivering superior returns for a long period of time.
Following the issues of 08, some people believe a fund of hedge funds are not going to be relevant going forward. What's your take on that?
Quite the contrary. Flows of monies into hedge funds and funds of hedge funds have been increasing over the last two quarters. And Deutsche Bank recently came out with a study that said 82% of consultants saw a dramatic increase on the part of their clients to hedge funds. Mm-hmm. Of course, if you don't have the asset base or the expertise to invest directly with multiple hedge funds, then you're going to come to an experienced fund of hedge funds like ours. The reason that there are these increased flows is that long-term investors are looking at statistics, and over the last 10 years, hedge funds and funds of hedge funds have outperformed the S&P 500 on an absolute return basis, not to mention, you know, a risk-adjusted basis, which people are very mindful of now that the market has bounced, you know, from its 2009 low. So I think this is a great opportunity. Also, we've got to remember that it's been the survival of the fittest, and the weaker, the poor-run funds of hedge funds didn't survive 2008, whereas the better ones and stronger funds of hedge funds did.
Amanda, how will you position Pan Reliance for the future?
I've been doing this for 20 years, and I hope that over the next 20 years that we can deliver the same type of superior risk-adjusted returns with substantially less volatility. As an example, over the last 20 years, we've outperformed the S&P 500, but we've had less than half the volatility. We will strive to continue to deliver very attractive risk-adjusted returns through multiple cycles, and to stick to our investment philosophy of tracking a small universe of managers whom we know very well and upon whom we do very due diligence. In addition, we're always going to keep our eyes open for emerging managers who could show great promise in the portfolio. And we also want to be very efficient in the terms of use of technology and personnel. And lastly, we always want to be mindful that a black swan event could be just around the corner.